sweet ones. So I did a very, very random video on my other channel. I will put a link below. I tried to explain there what I meant, but I think I didn't do a good job. So I will try again here. I have a plan. First of all, right now I'm going to do the climb every mountain spread. That is one of my favorite layouts for now. And I will use this Wicca Oracle deck. And yeah, what I tried to, this backside here, what I tried to, this is not a lot of cards, so we will use many of them. Well, yeah, I just, and they have like sparkles on each of the cards. I was attracted to that. I like sparkles a lot, so.
Is no longer welcome.
time to sweep it out the door. Act with honor and honesty to rid yourself of whatever may be holding you back from happiness. Cleanse, release, dismiss. I release what no longer serves me. And a challenge here is our question, what is cluttering up your spiritual space? So I also think about the topic of the chakras. I started with the first chakra and then I started working so much with the first chakra. I'm not very grounded generally, but these are things like those physically cleaning your space also. Everything is connected, everything is one and affects all levels or dimensions. But I feel very much more grounded. I feel that I like that also. I'm much less on Facebook, and I have found, what can I say, I have not spread myself out as thin as before, which I like. I feel very happy about the choices I've done recently, and that I feel so much more so grounded. And therefore also I like to keep that and not get swept away, you know. Also when it comes to the videos, therefore I thought about preparing them maybe in advance and upload them sometimes later. I just wanted to show the sparkly thing there, but I don't think you see it well. Here's the backside of the booklet where I read from. So yeah, anyways, I have not left you, and if anyone really, really crave me, I will do something at least for you and upload it. Meanwhile, I prepare the other ones as well to bombard you with to come. I'm not left. I love to do the videos and I will keep doing this. Okay, this is, what is my attitude? Let's see. And this is, how to see the number. Hope I show the number in the video. Something that has been coming for a long time is about to arrive. Give full attention now to any dream or wish that has long been hidden in your heart, for the time is auspicious. Beginning of auspicious beginnings is here. Purity, beginning light, I welcome goodness into my life. How can you purify your spirit? This is our attitude to bring new life, for to come into new life ourselves maybe. And also the thing I talked about for myself, just this can relate to other things for you, obviously. I just related to me since I can't talk to you exactly right now. I mean in a conversation with you, so I can't listen to you. Mainly I can talk, obviously. And I'm sorry that I don't talk too calmly right now, but so also the saving of money, although it have been Christmas and everything, I've been able to save up. I made a plan. Oh, this is also very related to survival, the first chakra and everything. I have followed up on down things that I've not managed to do as good before. So now I feel really not on top of the game, but I feel like, wow, things are starting to become stable in another way than before, which feels great. Well, and that is also this new things, I feel like, for me. Anyway, when should I begin is the next question here. I think I just wanted to see how long the video had been on for. Yeah. When should I begin? Let's see what this card says about that. Here. Well, let me see if I show the number 28. Maybe the 28th of something of January. But it says, we folk, fairies, gnomes, and elemental beings of all sorts, share the earth with us and are part of its magical essence. Here you see them there. And there's more houses on the trunk of the tree. I'm sorry I wave around so much. I suck when it comes to the webcam, I know. So maybe I should just not show, just put up pictures of the cards, upload them from Google or something. I don't know. Maybe you prefer that. Maybe I should test it on you. Okay, let's see. You might catch a glimpse of them from the corner of your eye or simply sense their presence in some secluded spot. Seek them where their world and our world meet, amongst the roots of ancient trees, on the misty mountain tops, and at the edge of the sea. There are helpers willing to pitch in and give you the assistance you need on a cause or project that is dear to their heart as well. Look around you, let your need be known, and welcome help when it is offered. I think when should I begin is right now, and also to ask for help here. And some time ago I filmed a little bit around here when I could upload from my phone, and we have those fairy rings, like mushrooms in large rings here on this side of the, there is a river in this town, in the middle of the town, and I've always felt a different energy on this side. I moved a year ago to this side of town, and the energy here is so different. I constantly use the word magical, but it is. I didn't connect it with fairies before, but then I saw these rings, and many of them pretty close to here, and it's not very common. Yeah, and I feel their presence. So I think I should go there and talk to them a bit. Yeah. Anyways, so in some place that you feel that they can, where they can be, maybe you also should. Nature's presence, and it's listening to us. So, yeah. Help community details. I give thanks for helpful friends. What elemental beings do you sense near your home? I love to live and be here where I live now. I think I will live in this apartment for the rest of my life, maybe. Maybe somewhere else as well, but I love to be here actually, in this particular place. I hope you do too, wherever you are. So, and then, what is my challenge? Is the next card for us here. Masks both conceal and reveal. When you've done a mask, you present another face to the world. You put on perhaps a part of yourself you do not dare to show in everyday life. Ceremonial masks allow the wearer to embody their powers that can possess mere humans with divine inspiration. Some part of yourself that you may be repressing wants to be set free. Look within and see what alter ego, or what was the word? Well, anyways, needs to come to the surface. Be bold. Let your true self emerge. Or as there was this word, archetypes. Yeah, she used what kind of archetype? Maybe for those who use words like that. Persona, self-expression, embodiment. I show my true face to the world. What do you think you are is the challenge. So this question for the place where the card is what is my challenge? So this is our challenge. Why? Who do you think you are? And maybe we have a wrong perception of who we are. Maybe we are much more or other things as well. Anyway, so we could try it. And also, maybe you've heard the expression, fake it till you make it. And I don't think that is about to be false. It's about connecting, tap into, and try on another costume, you can say, or another way of being, and maybe find those things within. Also, yeah, like actors actually pick up things from themselves and maybe also channel spirit well more often than they know, but yeah. So this is the challenge, ritual masks. This also bringing these new things forth. This next, how shall I meet this challenge? 13, is it the number? What number was it? No, I don't think so. I think it was something else. Her fold, protecting it as it learns to stand on its own and explore the wide world. The mare symbolizes unconditional love, the tenderness of the great goddess for all her children. There is nothing stronger or more enduring than mother love. Give yourself without reservation to those you love and receive their love in return. Such freely given love is nourishing and sustaining to all your endeavors. It is safe to open your heart. Nurturing, nourishment, protection, I give my whole heart in tender love. What part of you aches to be loved? So this is how we shall meet this challenge of wearing a new mask, or letting new things, new parts of ourselves come forth to love all that we are, our whole selves, and also share it with others and let others love all that we are. What will happen if I give up? Is this 31, chariot of fire. The solar chariot blazes across the sky, drawn by two fiery horses. Their daily ride through the heavens symbolizes success and perseverance, pushing through any obstacle to achieve a desired goal. The way through is made clear, all roads are opened, and obstacles cannot stand against the force of the celestial steeds. The time for contemplation is over. Oh, sorry, I wave around so much with the card. Take the reins of your life in your own hands and take action immediately. Your boldness will be rewarded by good fortune. Action, will, forcefulness. I am filled with courage and confidence. Where in your life are you moving too slowly? So, you should not guess that we should do what we have thought about doing for maybe a long time. Action. Actually do it. And not to gradually or slowly just go and do it. So, and not to give it up. Absolutely not. The opposite. And maybe this is, when I think of these cards, of also this bringing forth this new self is about happiness also within. It's always, we all search for that in some sense. We may have it as well, but this is what happens if I persevere. So, okay. Did I not see the number? No, I didn't. Butterfly, I found it. 24. A butterfly's life is brief, like ours also, although it feels sometimes long maybe, but it's freaking short. An expression of beauty that dances upon the breezes and is gone. Its message is to make the most of each day, drinking in the earth's flowering grace from the moment of its emergence. Emerge from the cocoon, the butterfly unfolds its wings to the sun. It symbolizes the soul's awakening, expanding to receive the blessings of divine light. There is no need to make decisions now, just let life flow gently by for the time being. See the beauty in all things and live fully in the moment. Wonders are all around you, just waiting to be appreciated. Transition, beauty, wonder. I rejoice in beauty. What is the most wondrous experience you know? And this may seem like the opposite of these horses, this chariot of fire, but actually maybe the thing we should go all in and fully into is the presence, to live now, not postpone the things we wish for and wish to feel, but be in, find the happiness we have in the now and see the paradise we live in right here and now. To open our eyes to the things, not what we seek far ahead or far away or so. Okay, this is who offers me help, and this is Raven. And Raven make me think of the High Priest in Wicca. Actually, I was initiated, I think it was 97, into a coven as priestess, Wiccan priestess, and this make me think about the High Priest. Sacred birth of death and endings, the raven brings the message of time passing. The leaves fall, the nest is empty, and there comes a season for contemplation of loss. The raven's wisdom is that all things must pass, and that clinging to the present is useless. Understanding the cycles of life makes acceptance of change easier to bear, as well as making each moment precious as it passes. Beautiful. Connected to the butterfly there. There is a time for grieving, and to deny it is to prolong it in many cases. Find a safe time and space to mourn your losses, then rise above them as the rye raven flies and see the bigger picture, for blessings may accompany loss. Ending cycles, grief, also to let go of the old self sometimes, what we leave behind in many ways. I accept the lessons of change. How has sorrow served you? To me, this is a blissful ravens. If you've seen Kundun, one of my favorite films, when he was born, the myth at least says that there were ravens on top of the houses there, crying out. And oftentimes when happy things happen or special things, I hear them around. I mean, I hear them sometimes, other times too maybe, but I think there are bringers of blessings to me, that's what they mean. And it was the card of Joy Coven in Stockholm that I was initiated into, for anyone who are into Wicca and interested. I guess all Wiccans or witches in Sweden derive from that coven, more or less. Maybe not the Dianic. Okay, here is the fox. And what will I discover is what the place means. fearlessness and great skill in survival. These qualities are needed on the path of weak as well. The fox sign symbolizes the ability to be self-sufficient. Yeah. To move with discretion. Oh. And to act swiftly when the timing is right. There are opportunities for gain, but do not be tempted to act in an unethical or dishonest manner. Use your intelligence to find the best way to achieve your goal without cheating or taking advantage of the weak. Cunning, strategy, ethics. I use my powers for good. Where are your ethics in question? Yeah. You will discover this. I think it's about, that you survive the losses and also can find strength in them. Realize how sufficient you are. That we actually, I think we all have access to everything we need at the moment. It's there. We may not reach it all the time. We may be blocked a bit to grab it, let's say, but this is about a bit, I don't know if this would be related to the first chakra, but to me it's also related about coming home, landing sort of in yourself, knowing where you stand in yourself, not to be pulled in all directions by others. So, what is my reward? This is what this place where this card is. What is our reward? And let's see. This made me think actually of the high priestess of that coven, who in it said to me, to Wicca, she had a mandrake. She's the only one. I've never had one, and she's the only one I know who had one. And I just want to mention quickly that some people talk about these traditions and being initiated by those who have, should come from Gardner or whatever. And she was initiated by an Australian witch, Martin. I met him once. I think his name was Martin, yeah. And then she initiated a lot of people in the and it spread out over Sweden, let's say. So that he initiated himself, this Australian witch, where that tradition sort of come from, but it come from many sources, of course. They've learned let's say, not just from winning. Okay, reading. The plant world exists in mythical relationship with the human world, each serving the other to heal, nourish, and grow. From food to medicine to poison to mind expansion, plants offer ancient green magic. The mandrake is symbolic of the kinship between mankind and plants, suggesting a common origin. Literally, we are one with nature. Yeah, Wicca is celebrating this, for me that is. The earth cries out for our attention and care. Make it part of your spiritual and magical practice to do your part for ecology. Devotion to the goddess and God demand it, and your chosen spiritual path requires it. Ecology, nature, environment. I am connected to all living things. Challenge, how do you replenish yourself in nature? First was challenged the broom there, and here's Imbolc. Our attitude, this new beginning. So, just trying to make it sparkle for you, but it doesn't pick it up, I don't think. This was, when should I be? This was, when should I begin? Yeah. Dropped it. So the fairy people ask for help and begin now, I think that means. And what is our challenge? The mask, and I think in this case it's in a good sense to try on a new mask, to let the what we identify previously with, just let it go and try on something else and see what happens. Thank you for sweet words and comments and likes and so on.